So Germany have missed out on the men's singles with Li Chengwei defeating Mark Schwebler. But Germany have a chance of a title here at the Indonesia Open in the women's singles, which is next up on the court, because the World Championship bronze medalist Juliane Schenk, the number 4 seed here, is up against the Olympic champion Li Chengwei. After that, we'll have men's doubles and we'll finish off with mixed doubles here on finals day.
Women's single, the final. From China, Li Xuerui.
So Li Xuerui, 22-year-old from Chongqing in Sichuan province, beaten finalist last year, despite having too much points in the second game against Simon and Abel.
From Germany,
Juliane Schenk, 30 years of age from Great Old in Northwest Germany. Nations represented. That's a very healthy situation for the world of badminton. The 3-times four-in-a-row winner and defending champion Simon Awol, who was trying to reach the final for a 5th consecutive time, thwarted by Juliane Schenk in 3 games. But it was quite an extraordinary match. World ranking gone up to number 3. And that is since the seeding was done. Her win-loss record for the year translates into 2 previous finals, the German Grand Prix and also the India Super Series event. Now, her last 3 matches have gone the full distance as the German, first of all against Ingeriko Hiroshi of Japan, and then in the quarterfinal against number 8 seed Taisu Ying from Taipei. And then yesterday's semi-final, I can tell you she was 12-6 up in the first game and then promptly lost the next 15 points to lose the game, 21-12. But as you can see, came back well in the second and third, coming through in 53 minutes. So to Li Xuerui, as I say, the world number 1. But her win-loss record for the year for the world number 1 has been disappointing by her own very high standards. Reached the final at the Asian Championships in Taipei, where she lost out to her teammate Wang Yihan. But when you think that last year she played 13 tournaments, reached 9 finals, winning 8 of them, 9-4 for this year so far, is a bit different. More like the rest of us contenders rather than the champion that she is. Well, she struggled in her semi-final yesterday, the only one of her matches to go the full distance against Ip Bui Yin, the player from Hong Kong, of course, who had put out the former champion and reigning world champion Wang Yihan in the first round. So this is the 7th meeting between these 2 players. And as you can see, Juliane Schenk has only won 1 of them. But most importantly, it was the last one in the quarterfinal of that Denmark Open last year. As you can see, 2 straight games. In fact, of their 6 previous meetings, only twice has it gone the full distance. So there are umpire Hong Wai Sung from Hong Kong, and Leon from Malaysia.
Thank you.
Well, skipping the bounds, not really eager to get on with it, but Juliane and I have just noticed that while she had her knee strapped yesterday, Xuerui, the strapping looks to be even heavier today on her left knee. Anybody who's watched her play before, the 30-year-old, will know what a physical player she is. She holds the record at the moment for the fastest smash of the tournament.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Juliane Schenk, Germany. And on my right, Xuerui, China. Xuerui to serve, level play.
So last year's beaten finalist, the current Olympic champion, Xuerui.
Service over. One low. Service over.
Champion.
One all.
Jim, I've already mentioned that Juliane Schenk is very physical player. She's very, very fit. She will run and run all day. Also, as we saw yesterday, she's got a big smash. But she does rely very heavily on her physicality. Perhaps doesn't have the full array of shots, deceptive shots that her opponent possesses.
Two, one.
I'd be very interested to see these bandits that Xuerui has. I can understand when you have something on your knee, but it just looks like it's going all the way up to the
3-1.
I'm interested to see how she moves, because if that's something that Juliane can see straight away, she will take advantage of it.
As an independent player, so no coaches on her coaching bench. Preferred to not have coaches' involvement even when she was under the federation. Preferred to just stick to her own game plan. But any ideas that I had concerns, that obviously the player is not necessarily in dispute but has a different opinion to the federation, it must be a little bit upsetting, or at the very least upskittling. There's been no sign of it this week.
So
it's been absolutely focused on the week.
I always thought once more for the last couple of years that she's always been so independent from the federation. I don't think it makes a difference. She's totally alone. I don't know, but I'm pretty sure she's controlling most of the things herself. She's very, very, very. She's not good. They're not going into her, so that doesn't make any difference.
Yeah.
So I think if there has been a dispute, and I don't know the dispute, I think maybe it's a helper because she is so
independent.
She wanted her way.
Well, obviously her way works. I mean. Yeah. Here she is, she's in her seventh Super Series tournament final. Only won one of them.
Service over. Five, and six.
Marks the Singapore Super Series last year.
I think she has to be careful, Juliane, playing that close to the net. Lee has already shown her technique up there is superior.
Service over. 7-5.
Alluding to a little earlier on, you know, these overhead shots of Xuerui, you just can't tell which way it's coming. When is she going to play the hard smash? When is she going to slice it? When is she going to drop it?
Therefore, it's also important for Juliana not to play back those shots yet, because she is so good up there, she has to lift, and then that's a big problem.
So many shots that against other players they would expect to be winners, because Juliane Schenk's fighting qualities within the rally are fairly exceptional. But she has had victories over number one players like Wang Shoshian, Wang Xin, Wang Lin, who's just announced her retirement, and of course her opponent of today, and Wang Yihan. So she's beaten all of the top Chinese players at some point.
First of all, her fighting spirit.
Nine.
Of course, that helps. Signals, she has maybe not such a traditional style that they're not really used to playing. So some of the things that might be working against other opponents is not really working against Juliana. So they're going to have to change their game quite a bit. Just had that one day where things are not working for you, and Juliana's all over the game.
Hey, nine.
The German who has
the advantage of the mid-game interval. Just 1 point in it though. Yesterday, after that extraordinary opening game against Simon Awol, that if ever it was a time when a player needed a coach when they've just lost 15 straight points, having led 12-6, to then lose the game 21-12. But all credit to Juliane Schenk, she came back, so her mental toughness.
20
must
seconds.
Be absolutely extraordinary. That would have destroyed an awful lot of players to lose 15 straight points in a Super Series semi-final and not Juliane Schenk.
No, this shows her character.
Yeah.
But also, we have to remember players, it can be done. You know, players used to not having coach rule. Before, we didn't have coaches.
No.
So, of course, it can be done. I don't think these top players,
11,
most of the time,
10.
know what to do.
Too reliant on coaches now?
They know what to do. It's for the coach, the player situation. I think it's more kind of like finding out how is it going to work
11,
when the coach is coming in. In her case, she's just decided, oh, I don't need it. I'm not going to use my time on working on that part. I know what to do. Trust me, she's done her homework. Yesterday after her game, or last night, she's probably been watching video and she probably has notes how to play this array. And so I think more players could learn from this.
I used to keep a diary and of all the players, all my opponents, and note their strengths and their weaknesses. And every time I played them, I'd write in the diary again of how I won points, where I was getting caught out. And now players don't need to do that in a way because the coaches are doing it for them.
But
I'm a great believer that the players, you know, as much as the coach can give advice, at the end of the day, it's the player who's out there and has got to play the match.
Yeah. Therefore, it's very important, and I think for the new generation growing up with this new system, it's very important for them to understand that the knowledge has to come within themselves and not looking off the back all the time and looking
11.
For the solution.
It's interesting. I can remember a couple of years ago, Li Yongbo, head coach to the Chinese national team, said that both Bao Chunlai and Chi Jingfeng were too dependent on coaches. So obviously the Chinese system is, whilst they have got coaches here sitting on the coaching board, the back of the court, he still is a great believer in players working out for themselves.
Yeah.
And look at the success of the Chinese players. Other nations should learn from that.
They should indeed. I'm a great believer in that as well. I just have that feeling when you're knows what to do. He's that quicker, or she's that quicker in her head. It will come quicker to them. And they won't panic so much.
So 5 points since the mid-game interval. And here are 5 points going to Xuerui.
Service over.
Quality.
15.
Yeah, you can see this what he's talking about. Some people will say, yeah, look what the coach says. Lee went on the run there, but after being behind and things not really working, he worked it out himself.
Yeah.
Now she's back into the match. Now Lee, and of course he's good enough for it, but if now Lee, now that Lee doesn't know what's, you know, what is he supposed to do now?
Does it number?
Deep into the forehand corner, and immediately a fast angled shot
14.
Down the German's backhand side.
That is so sharp. See, Juliana knows it's coming, but still can't get it. To the shuttle, taking it high constantly, especially on the front court, putting so much pressure on Schenk.
Four
straight points just when you thought it was very close at 14-15. Olympic champion just applies the pressure, ups the intensity.
Game point, 14.
German at full stretch. Means that the Olympic champion has six game point opportunities. Well saved.
Second over. 15. 10.
Juliana actually there jumping up, showing a smash. Afterwards, something she did really well yesterday was that the whole tournament.
Oh, that's nice. Oh, so too is that.
15, 20.
Looked like she at least already thought it was over.
Game
time. Third time of asking.
First game won by Xuerui. 21-16.
Number one seed, Xuerui. It's the opening game against Juliane Schenk.
21-16. So, having taken that opening game 21-16, last year's beaten finalist, Xuerui.
Service over.
Well, remembering back to
one
last year's
low.
Final against Simon O, she took the opening game there as well. At match points in the second, she won't be wanting to think back to that at all. She won't put those demons from her mind.
Service over.
I say she looks
one low.
Even more comfortable than yesterday. She's playing better today.
Juliane Schenk always gets a lot of spectator support because of her sheer style. They love her fighting spirit and her never say die attitude.
The crowd is also watching that she doesn't have a coach or
yeah.
anybody, so can't help feel
Service
okay.
Service over.
Feel support for
her. Two, all.
From Juliana in the other games of the tournament, that Lee is putting so much pressure on her, she's going to have to clear some more because she's not in a balance to attack all the time. You see that? Just that was a very good shot, but she's not in balance to use her power.
Four, three.
So she's having to use other options than the hard smash.
Service over. 4-0. Service over. 5-0. Service over. 6-7.
Conditions, so.
7-4.
Juliane, he doesn't know what's coming.
Oh.
Like, look at her reaction.
Yeah, because she's in a good base position in the center of the court.
She just can't.
Can't read it.
No. Very effective.
Service over.
Powerful smashes. 9-8.
Getting out.
guess correctly, but that was going a mile out. He needn't have played that at the backhand defence.
I suppose all is well that ends well.
That's a little bit of momentum shift.
Yeah.
once again, finding the mark.
It was a short lift. Oh, 2.31. That's the fastest smash of the week by any female player.
Service over. 13-15.
If Juliana keeps having success with these jump smashes, I don't think there will be many years from now we'll probably see women coming up in the new generation that will use that.
As a
14.
On a high serve.
15.
Not only on this obvious say chance, but more and more. We saw Ip do it yesterday, she did it all the time. I think it will come in. Singles is if your opponent can find that gap just in front of the service line. It's just you're gonna have to take that extra step longer than. That's just. She's constantly in defense at the net, Juliana. Balance in the back home. You can see right now Lisa Ray is really forcing her in defense at the net.
Level 16 all.
Does 7-6 in the second set to do it. She's doing that 16-17 now, so it's kind of like I think it's a target for her.
Oh.
She's, you can can see she's not hitting with full power. She's aware of the drift. Very clever.
Follow game. Level. Play.
Well, no German badminton player has ever won a title here at the Indonesia Open.
Service over.
That statistic.
One love.
Final game of the women's singles.
She has the drift against her, so she can push Juliane to the backcourt. And then she can come in.
Service over.
It's all wide.
Coaches were pretty, that's all the coaches did, it was pretty good to say move on, move on. You know, this is not the time to.
Yeah.
It's crucial right now.
Three
great defense.
In the backcourt and only play the net shot when she's really, really the first up there. Other than it's better than something like she's playing right now.
Eight. Five.
Juliane Schenk has decided in her own mind
She has to try and kill these net shots from her opponent. She's bounced on the last three.
Ten. Five.
Not as powerful anymore from the back door.
Straight points. Xuerui has a 6-point advantage as the change ends in the final time. Now both players have obviously enjoyed more success from that far side of the court as we look down, which means that that is where Juliane Schenk is going to finish the match from. But with this 6-point deficit, to be just too much to whittle away and come back.
20 seconds. 20 seconds. Play. Service over. 6-11. Service over.
What a super shot.
12-7.
Really shown the class here. Before that shot, she had two clears as well, which she controlled in the drift side. It's making it very difficult. Looks she's playing with a margin.
Two, three, four. Right now. interesting indeed. That's gone wrong as well. Xuerui
10
appeals
14.
To the umpire, but there's no overrule.
Service over. 11-16. Thank you. round is over. 17-15.
The best lady singles we've seen so far.
Yeah, no question.
Really good dancer.
Lori's okay. 17-15. Okay, play on.
Well, even the service judge saw that there was a...
Yeah, she was on the floor, so that's not really right. So.
No, it's not right at all. Perspiration is left on the court because the player has dived or ought to be knocked out.
18-15.
Exactly 1 hour this match has been in progress.
Last year, you didn't make it to the tournament in 2021. What
Forward three finals this year and three times. She's had to settle for second best.
This is Ati Kuwai representing the France to you.
Well, the seventh Super Series tournament final and the sixth time. Fails to give it her all. She's got a lot of fans here in Jakarta with her performance this week. The Xuerui takes her sixth Super Series title. Thank you.
Museum. How nice that the former greats from this host nation of this Premier Super Series event are heavily involved in the presentation party.